Hello everyone and welcome to our channel. Today we are going to make the most of leftover rice with our simple and delicious recipes. Before starting the video, like, share and subscribe to our channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all the post notifications. Let's start with dal chawal arancini. The ingredients are 1 cup leftover dal, 1 cup breadcrumbs, salt as required, 1/4 cup coriander leaves, 1/4 cup cheese cubes, 1 tablespoon ginger garlic paste, 1 teaspoon green chilies, 1/2 cup corn flour and 1 cup of leftover rice. First, in a pan, add some oil. Once it's hot, add the green chilies. You can also add mustard seeds or jeera or hing for more flavor. Then add ginger garlic paste. Then some coriander leaves and saute it for a minute. Add the dal. If you have leftover dal tadka or dal fry, you don't need to do this step. Once the dal is mixed in, add some salt, then cook till the water is dried out. Then transfer the dal in a tray or a plate. Add the leftover rice and mix it nicely. Apply some oil on your palm. Take about 1 tablespoon of the mixture, flatten it, place the mozzarella cheese cube in center and shape it into medium-sized balls. Dip it into the corn flour slurry. Then coat it completely with breadcrumbs. Repeat the same procedure for the remaining mixture. Fry it till nice and golden brown. For garnish, here I have some papad. I've cut them in triangles. I'm going to fry them as well. Our arancini balls are ready. Enjoy this amazing Italian twist to our homemade Indian staple diet. Next, we are going to make rice thepla or bhat ka thepla. The ingredients are 1 cup leftover rice, 1 teaspoon red chili powder, 2 tablespoon besan, 1 teaspoon green chilies, 1 teaspoon garlic, 1/4 cup coriander leaves, 1 cup wheat flour, 1/2 teaspoon cumin powder, salt as required, 1/4 teaspoon turmeric and 1/4 teaspoon caraway seeds. First, in a big bowl, add the leftover rice. Then using a potato masher, I'm going to mash the rice. If the rice is hard, then add 1 teaspoon of hot water and mash it. Once the rice is mashed completely, add all the ingredients, that is the wheat flour, coriander leaves, garlic, 1 teaspoon oil, red chili powder, besan, green chilies, turmeric, caraway seeds, that is ajwain, cumin powder and salt. Mix it nicely. Apply oil on.
Pa 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 p
Cook the theplas till you get this brown spots on both the sides. Serve these delicious theplas with some plain yogurt or any khatta mitta pickle. Now let's make a dessert out of the leftover rice. The ingredients for rasgulla are 1 cup leftover rice, 1/2 cup maida, 1 cup sugar, some cardamom pods and 1/4 cup of corn flour. So first, in a steel mixer grinder, add the rice and blend it into a smooth paste without adding any water. Then take a steel plate, apply oil all over it and transfer the rice paste on it. Add corn flour, maida and knead it until it forms a soft dough. You can also add some milk powder if you have for extra flavor. Apply oil on your palms. Take a small portion of the dough and give it a smooth round shape. Then add sugar in a pan and add 2 cups of water to it. Let the sugar melt completely. Once it starts boiling, add 3 cardamom pods. You can also add 1/4 teaspoon of lemon juice for extra flavor. I could make 10 rice balls out of 1 cup of rice. Add these balls to the sugar syrup and let it simmer for 10 minutes. Then cover it with a lid, but don't cover it completely or else the rice balls might break. Then let it cook for more 10 minutes. Rice rasgullas are ready. Cool them down and treat your family to this delicious recipe today. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more amazing recipes.